One of the most terrible things to run away from are messages that promote dead works. Run away. Go for messages that makes you focus on God. He said repentance from dead works and faith in God. This is what God calls humility. When your whole heart is focused on him. Shavalima. You see what? Nebuchadnezzar had a dream and saw a large image. And the head of the image was gold. The breast was silver. The waist was brass. And then he was looking for interpretation. And Daniel comes with the divine interpretation and says, sir, you are the gold. God has made you the gold. Jesus Christ. The moment Nebuchadnezzar heard the interpretation of a dream, that was what God has made him in the spirit. And he was enjoying it. God has made him gold. The whole world was under his feet. That was his dominion. You don't need any physical thing to enforce it. When God gives you honor in the spirit, you don't need any physical teaching of loyalty to enforce it. The moment the man got the interpretation of his dream, he made a golden image and said, now I know who I am. I am a gold in the spirit. He made a golden image and said, everybody worship that golden image. God said, the Bible said, I will show you. He told him, I will show you. He made him an animal to eat with animals for 7 years. When he came back, Nebuchadnezzar himself, he said, now I know that everybody must be humble before the God of heaven. God is so complicated and dangerous that he can give you this. The moment you stop looking at him to look at this, he gets angry at this. You have made this an idol and a god. He will turn back and fire this and fire you. So the whole agenda is that I gave you this, but don't look at this. Keep looking at me. The mighty things God is doing in your life, don't use that to attack people. Don't use that to let people feel that you are the only one God is blessing. Be careful. If you shut up, you keep working. The day you start using it on people, you see that it has stopped. Everything that left your hand physically to enter your conscience stopped. Whatever God is doing with you, let it remain outside your conscience. Let only God consume your conscience. Otherwise, you will end up losing everything that he's doing in your life. He said he gives more grace to the humble. And now you know who a humble person is. Someone who has submitted his conscience to God. And he said God resisted the proud. Who is the proud? Someone who has filled his thought with everything apart from God. So your thought is full of your ambition, your dreams, your plans, your 10-year plan, your 30-year plan, and all that. They are all powerful. But when they are not in line with God's will, that is how you become a proud person before him. And the Bible says he will keep resisting you. Submit yourself, therefore, to God. This is the mystery. Submit, just submit. Lord, I submit my will to you. I submit my emotions to you. I submit my plans to you. This marriage, I submit it to you. It's all about you. This ministry is all about you. This gift I have is all about you. I submit everything. And take it. Lord, take it. So give yourselves humbly to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. So how do you resist the devil? By resisting things outside from entering your conscience. You got 50,000 cedis. Let it remain in your accounts. Let it not enter your mind. You got married. Let that ring remain in your hand. Let it not enter your mind. It will fight God in your conscience. And when you don't take care, everything about the marriage will be dead works. You are not going to prosper because you married. You are going to prosper because God is with you. The marriage is only a complement. It's in part of his plan. But the world has a way of corrupting our conscience, making us feel that it is certain things that will... No. You got that degree, that certificate. It's powerful. God is saying that let the relevance of that degree remain on the paper. Let it not enter your mind. Still believe that it is God that will lift you up. And this is how we resist the devil. When you allow things to remain outside, certificate has its place in a drawer. God has his place in my conscience. Listen, ministry has killed more pastors than anything. There is a way you can be so consumed with what you are doing in church that you don't have time for God. And the people will rather fill your mind and God will leave. And when you draw close to God, God will draw close to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and let your hearts be filled with God alone to make them pure and true to him. Let your heart to do what? Be filled with God alone. So when we say someone has a pure heart, that pure heart is not that when you do him anything, he forgives you or anything. It's when God fills that heart. Let your heart be filled with God alone to make them pure and true to him. Most of us, our hearts are lying to God. It is us that you are telling us that you love God, but to him, your heart is far. In Matthew 7:21, he says, some who call me Lord, Lord, did I not prophesy in your name? It was a physical thing. Deep within, your conscience was not connected. You were prophesying to just begin to share envelopes and take seed. Any spiritual gift you demonstrate with a different motive apart from fulfilling the will of God was a dead work. The Lord told me the reason why I told you never to minister anywhere and take honorarium. He said I was killing self. Yesterday I went to a function and someone was asking me, I've heard you don't take honorarium. What is the profit? What have you gained out of it? I looked at my smirk. I said, what I've gained is that I have nothing to lose preaching God. So I go everywhere with one focus, that I will release an aspect of God to people. It's not that I have a share in the offering that will come. If I don't have a share, then I must give God. He said, when I was leaving, I told you that don't serve mammon and God. This will be what will challenge people. Money will be the reason why people will lie. Money will be the reason why they will not teach sound doctrine. Money will be the reason why they will do fake stuff. Money will be the reason why. And if I really want you and I really want to serve my purpose with you, I will cut your heart off money. Many of you have so many plans for the things you are doing for God. The end of the plan is that he will give you marriage. Your conscience is so defiled. So most of us have contracts with God. One time I heard a preacher say that Christianity is a business. If you don't know how to strike a deal with God, you are doomed. Hey, you are striking a deal with God. It is only in this generation a man of God can tell you, come and sow a seed and let me pray for my anointing to come on you. When in Acts chapter 8, Simeon took money, he said, let me give you money so that you pray the Holy Ghost to come. He said, your money perish with you. How did this generation get here? And they have excelled because your eyes are not open. I'm not teaching you not to give. You get to a point. This man standing before you has emptied his account several times for the church. I'm not telling you not to give. But do things out of a certain connection you have with God. Just this week, God revised my offering. He said, from today, this is how much you'll be giving in every service. I said, God, what is this? There is a way you can have a relationship with God that he teaches you, he directs you. You don't need any other gimmicks. He directs you on everything you do. And he makes sure that you do it because you want to honor him. If you tell me, why are you a pastor? And what are you expecting God to do for you? I don't even know. I'm just doing it. I die for you. That I should shift your mind to what I want. I will keep on letting you see God. He will direct you to how he wants you to be. If he will never give me a mega church, I don't care. What I care is that I will do what is not in his will. That one I can't stand. So if I keep on doing his will and then he will spread us abroad in the whole world, that is fine. My job is to keep doing his will. What he wants, I do it. This is how many of us have missed him, because our conscience have not been right. But we are doing good things. Singing is powerful. Fasting is powerful. This week from tomorrow we are fasting. What will be your conscience? It's because of the wrong motives. That is why many of us have stopped doing some good works. Because we did it from a wrong motive. We didn't see what we wanted to see. And today we have stopped doing it. But if your minds are filled with God, you keep on doing it, because it's not about you. It's about him. So he tells you to keep interceding. You keep on interceding. It's not that, Lord, I've interceded. He told me if you intercede, you'll go far in life. I've been interceding for 3 years. I'm still where I am. And because of that, I think I have to think about my own future. You are dealing with a God who says that I know the thoughts that I have towards you. I know. It's in here. I have a thought for everybody. It's in here. So why? What are you doing with your own thoughts? When he is saying he has a thought for you. So when Jesus came in Matthew chapter 6, he said that do not think of what to eat, what to wear. God is already thinking. You too, what will your thinking do? God is already thinking and planning for your future. You are also busily distracting his thought with your little mind. So Jesus said, don't think about what to drink, what to eat. He says that your Father in heaven knows that you have need of them. He is planning and thinking for you. Your Father knows already. He knows. He knows. He has thought that you are living in Ofancor. In Ofancor, there is no tarred road. In Ofancor, there is no flowing of water like that. In Ofancor, in Ghana, there is no light system, a permanent light system. God knows everything. He is thinking. Allow him to think. And he says that what you have to do is to keep seeking the kingdom and his righteousness. Just keep seeking the kingdom. And he said that, and all these things, remember, he says that your Father knows that you have need of these. these things. And he said, keep seeking the kingdom and all these things shall be added. The reason why the supply of heaven has delayed is because of one thing. You have been distracting the thought of God with your own thought. Job said, I have esteemed your word above my necessary food. I wake up, I sleep thinking about God. Then he says he will do the thinking. He knows how to fix the protocol around me. He knows how to fix the ushering. He knows how to fix the technical. He knows how to fix it. The day I take that responsibility from him, I will die early. Why do you want to get high blood pressure now? Celebrate God all day, every day. I mean, revel in him. Do you know what revel is? You become so intoxicated about somebody that it's like you are mad about the person. Just revel in him. But today they want to teach us that, no, you must think about that. You must plan about this. You must think about that. No, you say, for scriptures, God, make it as clear as you can, all you meet, that you are on the side, on their side, working with them and not against them. Help them to see that the master is about to arrive. He will show up any minute. Don't fret or worry. Instead of worrying, pray. Let petitions and praises shape your worries into prayers. Let God know your concern. Before you know it, a sense of God's wholeness. Somebody says, sense of God's wholeness. Everything coming together for good will come and settle you down. It's wonderful what happens when Christ displaces worry at the center of your life. When Christ displaces worry. So, listen, when you genuinely pray with God, you are not worrying and you genuinely pray to him. What he gives you is Christ. Unto your whole mind and your whole heart is focused on Christ. That's the answer to the prayer of worries. When he becomes the center and he's the one you are looking up to, then he takes the thought of the others. When you are thinking, you think about one thing at a time. If you have 5 children, you think about Akusia, think about Ya, think about Kwedo, think about that. You think about all of them one after the other. But he says when Christ fills your heart, he will rather work everything together. So he will combine all of them, think about them and set them at the right place for you. Is that not beautiful? My God. From today, something is shifting over somebody's life. I said something is shifting over our lives. Somebody say, I rejoice in the Lord. I rejoice in the Lord. Jesus is my focus. I look up to him. My conscience are clear. I do it for Jesus. Whatever I do, in deed and in words, I do it in the name of Jesus. My conscience are clear. I'm not doing anything because of myself. I'm doing all things because of Jesus. Hallelujah.